Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to the FordTechMakuloco channel. So today I have another sick 5.4 liter three valve engine that needs some loving. It's got a hole in its heart. Let's check it out.
Okay, so this 2009 Ford F-150 5.4 three valve engine has just under 200,000 miles on it. Now what happened with this engine is the usual, okay? But a little bit more this time, okay? So what happened is the tensioners blew out, the chains started beating on the guides, broke the guides up, little chunks of guides are floating around in there. And this can happen. Every once in a while I see it. A piece of the guide gets caught underneath the chain and lifts the chain off the phaser sprocket right here. Now when it does that, lifts it high enough that it actually makes the chain contact the valve cover. All right, so what'll happen is it'll lift the chain up and it'll crack a chunk of the valve cover off of there and it'll start spurting oil out everywhere in here. It's all wet because of that. What the customer did is he actually, to drive it onto the trailer and stuff like that, is he actually put on some JD Weld, looks like, on there to kind of cover it up so it stops shooting oil out. I'll knock that stuff off later when we get on the engine stand. But what happens is, once that chunk of the guide lifts the chain and then lets the chain back down onto the phaser, it actually mistimes the engine, makes it jump timing. So a lot of times, because this is an interference fit engine, it'll actually cause the valves in the head, the valves in the piston to contact. And once that happens, I mean, it's all over. I mean, it could be isolated, you could do a little bit of valve work, something like that, but for this guy, if something like that happened, it needs a timing set, needs exhaust manifolds, and it has 200,000 miles on it, he's like, just replace the engine, just be done with it, and do it right. So that's what we're going to do on this vehicle. Once I get the engine out onto the stand, I'll knock that stuff off of there, I'll show you how it looks, so you can identify it, and then we'll pull apart the timing system on there. And I'll show you how it looks when it jumps time. Real quick though, I'll show you what it looks like on the scansel. So it depends on the bank that it actually happened on, what code you actually get, all right? But you're gonna get some kind of timing error codes. And usually it's gonna be something where it thinks the phaser's off 345, 346, 340 code, something like that. You may get a 16 code or an 18 code. In this case, because it's over there on bank two, over there, well actually it's on bank one over there. Sorry about that. So bank two has an issue, which we're gonna show you here in a second. But the issue is with bank one on there. So the big mistimed event that's happening right now is happening just on bank one. So we have a 16 code. For that, I believe bank P0018 code is bank two, basically for a camshaft and crankshaft correlation, which means that the timing is so far off on that bank that it sets this kind of code on there. All right, and that's because the timing did indeed jump on there. So that's the major issue here, and then he also looks like it. Looks like the throttle body's all carboned up. Maybe I'll do a video on this one day. Basically, when you get this code, the 115E code, the throttle body has a certain amount of idle trim degreeing that it can do to make the engine idle. And once the throttle body gets so plugged up on there and it hasn't been cleaned in a long time, it'll kind of max out on there. So it's basically, the throttle body's angling too far just to maintain idle RPM. But let's concentrate on a timing error on here. So if you go to power balance, it won't even show a power balance on here because it knows the engine's too far out of whack as far as the cam crank correlation on there. So what we're looking at here is the VCT error pin, which basically can show you if the engine is mistimed on a VCT engine like this. So let me clear it out. It's been going for a while here. So you saw the code for bank two on there, and you can see why. That phaser, I mean, it's just all over the place. The signal's all over the place. This should be hovering, both of these should be hovering right around zero, All right. So you can see the signal is erratic at best on bank two. It's probably the phaser coming apart with this kind of mileage. But on bank one, you can see the side that has the cracked valve cover and the jump timing. You can see our signal's pretty consistent. You can see it's kind of hovering there, right? But it's hovering way out from zero. Whereas on bank two here, it's just kind of jumping here, 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 here. Whereas this one on bank one's pretty tight, but it's all the way over here in left field. Okay? It should be doing that same hover over here. So that right there tells you, without getting anything out and touching any kind of physical contact with the vehicle, no special tools out, no compression testing, no nothing, I can tell you it jumped timing. All right, it's sitting over there. All right. So again, once we get this apart and it's on the engine stand, I can show you how it looks and all that stuff and what exactly happened here. But it's pretty interesting stuff, and you know, it doesn't happen that often, but it is another one of those things to watch out for on the Ford 5.4 liter three valve engines. Oh, this thing sounds awful. Time for an engine. Oh, speaking of, there's a new one now. Alex is getting it prepped. Bring it into the stall, give it a heart transplant. All right, so here's the old crusty engine. We yanked it out, put a new Ford reman in there, sent him down the road, and now it's time for us to tear this one apart and show you what's going on inside of there. So here is the passenger side valve cover where I showed you the customer had slathered on some JB Weld to close it up kind of, because he wanted to be able to drive it, you know, short distances to get it on the trailer and stuff like that. And with this window open on here, as you can imagine, it's just slinging tons of oil out of there, making a huge mess. So he covered it up so he can drive it up in the trailer and stuff. So yes, this is how it's going to look when this happens, when the guides get trapped under the chain and get between the camshaft phaser sprocket and the chain. It will lift the chain up, press it into the valve cover here. It'll crack a window like this. It'll come up and over it, and it'll drop that piece of guide off of there, and it'll jump time, usually 1, 2, 3 teeth on there, all right? So that's what's happening. If you have a concern like this where it's broken and open like this, looks just like this, it's because the guide's got trapped, and you've jumped time at that point, all right? And you can see why. I mean, look at right here. My finger barely fits inside of there, won't even fit, and that's because the clearance is so close to the valve cover here that it cannot handle any kind of lifting of the chain. So once it happens, it just cracks a window in there and starts flinging oil. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna go ahead and pull the valve covers off, and we're gonna pull the front cover off so I can show you what's going on inside of the engine. Now, before I pull the front cover, I just wanna look at the valve tray on here with you to show you a few things on here. So the engine wasn't taken care of too well, not so bad, but not too well for 195,000 miles on it. What you'll notice in here is pieces of the guides. This is from the passenger side guide. I can tell by the ribbing on the back here that have come up through. So a piece like this, you know, a quarter size piece is all it takes to get trapped underneath there and right up and through. And this one looks pretty chewed up right here. It's not a clean break. So this one probably is the one that rode through there and lifted it. So we're going to use this one for a demonstration on here of what it looks like. But I just wanted to show you, you know, the engine was ready anyways. Pretty toasty inside here. So what I'll do now is I'll go ahead and put you up in the tripod. We open the front cover on here together. Once you pull the cover out, there's gonna be a lot of pieces falling out. It'll sound like Legos, you know? So all the bolts are out. Let's see. Yeah, see? So pulling it down here, the passenger side or driver's side is intact on here, but the passenger side's totally gone. All right, so this chain is free to flop around and do whatever it wants. We have one big piece right here. There's usually one bigger piece and then a couple smaller pieces, and sometimes it even just rides around in here and chews up into little pieces. Here's another piece. Like I said, you'll see a lot of pieces like this size. You know, they're prone to getting trapped underneath here. Here's another one. All right.
So what we'll do is we'll go ahead and get this out of the way. There's some more. You see these little pieces? These are the ones that are gonna get you into trouble, not the bigger ones, all right? So what we'll do now is I'll go ahead and put the bolt back in on the crankshaft here and I'll turn it. So right now it's ready jump time. The engine's ready trash. It's going back to Ford to get remanufactured. At this point, it just doesn't matter what I do to it. All right, so like I said, I'll use this piece that looks a little chewed up and I'll illustrate what happens inside of here. So all these little pieces, they're just kind of rolling around here, getting flopped around, thrown around, little pieces, right? Well, once they get up in here and they get pinched right here, they're gonna go for a ride up and around, all right? So let's try and make a jump time. So we'll go ahead and we'll mark this link right here to it, and we'll see where it ends up at the end there. And we'll just turn it manually. I should be able to overcome it. I got a big old bar for it. All right, here we go. There it goes. So they're rattling around, it gets pinched. And what's gonna happen is it's gonna be able to do it because this will give a little bit, naturally. Hope this doesn't break anything in my face. But you can see what it's doing already. See it, how it's lifting the chain like that? And like I said, the chances of that piece, these pieces getting caught underneath here are kind of, you know, slim, but it does happen every once in a while. So I'll keep going here. I'll look away. I think we're gonna be too far there. I think we're gonna lose it past here by the time this thing comes up and over. So right now we're still in time. Let's say this one and this one. How about that instead? All right, we'll keep going here. See how it's slacking it like that? And then it can go back around and get caught again, and it can actually cause a jump time in there. Now, again, it's happening real fast compared to what I just did. So let's try to do this. See if we can show it on here. So it looks like it makes it you know, jump about a tooth or so. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll do it once again. Get about the same size piece in there. So we can lift the chain like that. There we go. I'll mark it right here, we know, right? These two are together. Okay, it's pretty obvious. Can you see that? Yep, we can see that. All right, let's go around once more. And we'll check this one to see if it jumps one tooth or not. See, we're still lined up on there. It's trapped. And again, this is happening at a much faster rate than this, obviously. All right, we'll get you out of there. Now I'll go back. Yeah, it looks about one tooth each time. Okay, I'll get it over so you guys can see it really well.
So when it happens, it tends to go one tooth over, which, you know, on an interference fit engine, it could cause the valves to hit, but the chances of them actually hitting on there and causing permanent damage are pretty slim. I mean, beginning of my career, I mistimed the engine by a tooth or two and ran it, and there was no issues. Retimed it, everything's fine. So you can see we're off by the tooth too. A tooth, I mean. So there's one right here. There's one right here. So we went over one. So that's what's happening inside of there. Just so you guys know. All right. So it doesn't mean it's instant self-destruction of the engine, but it could mean that under certain circumstances, that valve and that piston can kiss and deform, you know? So you can see the rest of the engine. Yeah, it's dirty and everything like that, but there's no failed followers, nothing like that yet. You know, this one probably could have done a timing job and then down the road, but the customer's like 200K and everything's crusty on it. Everything's just ready to be replaced. Let's replace it and do it right. So that's what we did. But I just wanted to illustrate what goes on inside of the engine. To give you guys a better sense of what happens when these guides break. So again, this tensioner is blown out. Startup, this chain right here, it has a lot of slack in it upon startup. And this guide sits right here, okay? Right here. And that chain droops about here. And then it starts up and starts whacking it. Well, a big heavy steel chain against plastic, and it changes in a wind every day. And so then it'll break up into pieces eventually, and then they just start floating around here. And then it can get trapped, and it can jump time. Pretty darn simple. That's all for now. Hope you guys found this informative, and I'll see you guys next time.